Hello students, today we are going to explore areas of parallelograms on same base and between same parallels. For this activity, we require one graph sheet of paper and one rectangular sheet of paper for making parallelogram. So, first we make parallelogram through this rectangular sheet of paper. Let's make parallelogram. First, fold this paper like this so that corners overlap on each other. Then again fold this edge down this over down this edge, and third step, again fold this edge over this edge, and finally fold this like this so that this corner coincide with this corner, and here we make a parallelogram. As we know, parallelogram is a quadrilateral having opposite sides are equal and parallel, as we can see here. Now, let's start our activity. Areas of a parallelogram on the same base and between same parallels. We take these two parallelograms replicas and place it so that their base is lying on each other like this. And now we trace these parallelogram by marking the point and name it P, Q, R, S and T. We draw their sides by joining these points which we have marked. Now, what we observe that two parallelograms PQ RS and QTRS is made up of two triangle PQS and triangle QRS. And again, if we observe parallelogram QTRS, we find this parallelogram is made up of two triangle QTR and QRS. So, if we want to find area of these two parallelograms having same base SR and between same parallels PT and SR, so we have to find areas of these three triangles PQS, QRS and QTR. By finding areas of squares, complete squares, more than half squares, half squares and less than half squares enclosing in these triangles. So, let's start counting. Number of complete square in triangle, first we take triangle QRS. Number of complete square are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So, we find number of complete square is 20. In triangle SQR, number of complete squares are 20, and as we know, we take one complete square is equal to 1 centimeter square. So, 20 complete square is equal to 20 centimeter square. Now, let's count number of more than half square. Here, if we observe this triangle QSR, we not have any more than half square. So, let's come to half square, number of half squares. Here we find 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So, we have 10 half squares, which is equal to 5 centimeter square, and as there is no more than half square and no less than half square. So, if we add up these two numbers, we find 25 centimeter square. So, area of the triangle SQR is 25 centimeter square. Similarly, we can find area of triangle PQS. So, let's count the complete square. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Again, we have 20 complete square in triangle PQS, and again we count number of half square. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, we have 10 half square, which means it is 5 centimeter square as we have seen earlier in the case of triangle SQR. So, area of triangle PQS is 25 centimeter square. So, in triangle PQS, complete square are 20. So, it is equal to 20 centimeter square, as one complete square is equal to 1 centimeter square. And we find number of half squares are 10, which is equal to 5 centimeter square, as two half squares make one complete square is equal to 1 centimeter square. When we add up these, we find 25 centimeter square. And we can see that there is no more than half square and less than half square. So, area of triangle PQS is 25 centimeter square. Now, we come to triangle QTR. Here again, we start counting complete square. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. In this triangle also, we find number of complete square are 20, which is equal to 20 centimeter square, and number of half squares are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, here number of half squares are 10, which is equal to 5 centimeter square. So, again we have, when we add up these two figures, we find 25 centimeter square. So, area of triangle QTR is 25 centimeter square. So, what we observe that the parallelogram PQRS is of area 25 centimeter square plus 25 centimeter square is equal to 50 centimeter square. As this parallelogram PQRS is made up of two triangles, as we have seen earlier, PQS triangle and triangle QRS. Again, if we observe parallelogram QTRS, we find area is 50 centimeters square as it is made up of two triangles QTR and QSR, and these two triangles areas are 25 centimeter square each and it is equal to 50 centimeters square. So, we find areas of these two parallelograms PQRS and QTRS are equal and having the same base SR, and between same parallels PT and SR. Now, what we find that PQS and QTR, these two triangles are equal in areas. So, they are congruent to each other, and in this figure we find triangle QSR is common to both parallelograms. So, we find that these two parallelograms are equal in areas. Now, we can show that as these two triangles are congruent, so their angles P is equal to angle Q as PS and QR are parallel and PT is transversal, and these two angles are corresponding angles. Again, angle Q and angle T are equal because QS and TR are parallel to each other and PT is transversal, so corresponding angles are equal. As angle P and angle Q are equal to angle Q and angle T, so angle S becomes equal to angle R in these two triangles PQS and QTR. So, what we observe that in parallelogram PQRS and QTRS, these two triangles are equal in area as we have proved, and this triangle QRS is common to both of parallelogram. So, we find this two parallelograms area PQRS and QTRS are equal in area. So, we have verified by doing this activity area of two parallelograms PQRS and QTRS having same base and between same parallels are equal in areas.